like you. And how great is our God. Sing with me, how great. Church, we didn't have all kind of keyboards and organs and drum sets and bass players. We just lifted our voice and said it. How great is our God. And sing with me, how great is our God. And I'll see how great. How great is our God.
Clap your hands if you got more than $10 in your bank account right now. He's a great guy.
Happening, therapy, had to relearn how to walk, how to talk, how to play, how to do a lot. He's a great God. I'm giving you the abbreviated version. In 2012, I had my daughter, Symphony, and Miss Janet knows when I was a kid, I lived in St. Joe's Hospital. Bad asthma. To this day, I might heal it in my pocket right now. Bad asthma. When my daughter was born, she started wheezing and coughing, and we were in the hospital for the first 18 months, the same thing. And people around us would speak, and they'd be like, oh, Lord, you're going to go through it again. I said, the devil and all his friends are lying. So the last time she was in the hospital, I grabbed her, I was crying, and I just held on to her, and I spoke some things. I said, this is not going to happen. How many believe in generational curses? Because I'm going to break that right now. Ain't no such thing as a generational curse if you believe in a great God. I believe that my God can do anything at any time, any place, anywhere. We believe in the Bible that says that he is able to exceed abundant upon all we can ask or think according to a power that's already working in us. So I grabbed my daughter that day and I said, we will not do this again. And I said, if I got to beat the devil in the parking lot and fight him like a grown man, I would. I told you I just got saved yesterday. I'm about to take my jacket off now. And to this day, she's never been back. They tried to say that she had asthma too. I said, the devil and all his friends are alive. He's a great God. He's a great God. He's a great God. Hallelujah. The last thing I'm going to leave you with before we'll go back to my other post is everywhere we go, all over the world we minister, and we say, let your praise match your expectation. Very simple. Somebody got that? For those who didn't get it, allow me to elaborate. If you need something from God, let your praise match your expectation. So a lot of people got that. It's not like a few more people understood that concept. So we're going to say it one more time, just for the people. Let your praise